and wanted to showcase the two other games, but I wasn't able to start them at with Windows 10 late. Okay, I wasn't able to start them, and yeah, there were some comments indicated that they also had the same problem below the first video, and there was a link posted to the ongoing discussion and on the GOG forums, and yeah, looks like it is not that easy. And yeah, I didn't try out stuff like DXWND. There are tools that might help with this, but I wanted to go through the hassle. However, might be a solution. It's a bit complicated, so if you want to go for it, do it. It seems that GOG updated the installer, which either introduced this issue or doesn't make it possible that easy to fix it. Nevertheless, there's a fan page which you can use, and I will tell you what I did. I got Hannibal to work. Alexander's working out of the box. About Caesar, yeah, it is not that easy. So, what did I do? I'm running currently Hannibal. It seems to work. It seems to work. And I simply downloaded, it seems, the official patch, unpacked it, installed it over my GOG install. Then I got this patch here. It is a collection of all three games. There are a ton of exes inside of them. I don't know exactly what they all are about. It seems there is one standard exe, and there's one, let's say, hacked, modded exe in order to remove momentum, which seems to be not a liked feature in multiplayer battles, because I guess it is somewhat random or whatever, and there might be it's explained, everything is explained here. I just skimmed it. It removes the momentum, so from all of your games. Yeah, download those and install this on top. So first, I installed simply what I got from GOG, the Hannibal folder. Then I installed the Hannibal 1.2 patch on this folder, and then I installed overwrote the exes with this here as in the Hannibal folder. And then I start, and it works. Yeah, one thing which makes it even more complicated is if you have no CD drive, the game will say it won't launch in single player. So you need some sort of CD drive. I have, for example, Power ISO, which is creating virtual drives, and activate one of them, and then it's fine. So yeah, about Caesar. Caesar is running here, but it is not working correctly with this method, and it seems you need to get an older GOG installer. This here, 2001, 2016. Yeah, from where you get it, contact GOG support, it seems, and they will hand it you. They say, here, it doesn't run. Can I please have the old setup great battles CE blah blah blah? And they will say, okay. Several users report that they did it and got the file. I didn't do it yet, because I was hoping that I can work it out. But yeah, looks like Caesar. For Caesar, you need the old installer, and then do the same. Install with the old installer. Install 1.1 patch on top of it. Install this new exe on top of it. And then you can choose either start a game normally or start a game without momentum. Yeah, and add, of course, a virtual drive if needed, if you don't have a CD-ROM drive like many modern PCs don't have. However, I can start a game. The game is not working. I will get errors if I start a battle. But from what I've seen, yeah, let's start with Hannibal. I don't wanted to get into gameplay that much. I just want to show you what battles you have. From other than that, it looks quite similar. So this is the collection of battles you have for Hannibal. It also has. a campaign system similar to what we've seen in Alexander. Not exactly sure how it plays, but it, on the first glance, it looks quite something simple. Perhaps too simple for my liking, but yeah, looks like, you know, if I see the campaign space and the options you have, I can tell this is a rather simple campaign. So I personally would rather focus on the historical battles. And yeah, we can start one of those. And yeah, it could be that the game speed we saw in Alexander, I'm not sure if it is by nature or if it is perhaps some slowdown because of compatibility. Because I was thinking it's a bit too slow for my liking. Too very slow for my liking, how the units move. Okay. Mm-hmm. Hey, that's the sound from HBS, Ancient Warfare. This really strange elephant noises. Yeah, it could be really faster. I wouldn't even care if they blitz over the map. Especially if you have such a... such an army. This was our commander. Okay, yeah, that was a bit... moved him away. But other than that, it looks like this is a bit different. But other than that, it looks as expected. Yeah, I really like those sprites. Okay, yeah. I will keep the video short, and now we can take a look at Rome. Again, you have a campaign system, basically what we seen in the other games, something rather looks simple, and then we have the battles, which I can't showcase now, because if I start one of those battles, it will either crash or cause millions of errors, because I did the solution with contacting GOG support for the old installer in order to get Caesar working. So I can't also confirm to 100%, but it seems it works for other people getting this old installer. So if you really desire to get it, do it like this. Get this old installer, perhaps install all three games with this old installer. I don't know, I think one thing that was changed, I guess, was this CD-ROM issue. Yeah, but which you can fix with by a virtual drive. And about the speed, I can't say, I don't know, I've never seen gameplay of this game. If the speed is slower than it is intended, could be. This Hannibal felt a bit, but some of those games back in the days, they were like this. Yeah. Need to compare it with other footage. I'm pretty sure there's some YouTube footage of this game, as it was quite popular, it seems, back then. Okay, that's it. And now I will return the combat mission. And yeah, the link to this, I mean, you can copy it yourself here, all here. I simply hit the GOG forums, and the link is also, like I said, in the first video, where I showcase Alexander.